Hello, dear ones, Father Peter John, coming to you from Rose Hill Cemetery, Bloomington, Indiana. Christ is in our midst. We started this series on the 12 disciples, 12 apostles of Christ, talking about the holy, glorious apostle and evangelist John. And we are going to talk today about his brother, James. He and John together, collectively by Christ, were called the Sons of Thunder. What a title. You'll recall that James and John left their boats and their nets and their father Zebedee and followed Christ. Well, James was, together with his brother John and the apostle Peter, he was one of these close ones to Christ, who Christ included with him in particular occurrences in his life. For example, the Holy Transfiguration. You remember where he takes Peter, James, and John up onto Mount Tabor, where he's transfigured before them. So James had a very close and dear relationship with his Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. There's one instance in Luke's Gospel where Jesus sends ahead some representatives, you know, some people to go ahead and prepare a place for him in a certain Samaritan village as he's on his way to Jerusalem for his crucifixion. And when they get to the village, they find out that the villagers are not, they're not friendly to Christ. They don't want Jesus to come there. And the text says they don't want him to come there because he was going to Jerusalem from there. And so when James and John hear this, they say to Jesus, "Do you want us to call down fire from heaven to consume them?" You know, the Sons of Thunder. They were so defensive of their Lord, whom they loved so much. Well, James was, after the crucifixion and the resurrection and the ascension of Christ, the Apostle James went to Spain and other areas of the world and preached the gospel there fervently. Eventually, he came back to Jerusalem, and when the Jews found out that the apostle was coming back to Jerusalem, they hired a certain sorcerer named Hermogenes, and they wanted the sorcerer to, you know, use his powers to overcome James and basically try to kill his credibility in Jerusalem so they could prevent the spreading of the gospel there further. Well, when Hermogenes heard this, he was apparently a very prideful man, and he wouldn't even go and talk to James. He sent his disciple, whose name was Philetus. And so Philetus went to publicly debate James there in Jerusalem. And Philetus found that the wisdom of James's words was so overpowering, he couldn't speak anything in response. And so he went back to Hermogenes and said, there's nothing I could say in response to this apostle. He said, you know, you should leave your sorcery and become a disciple of James. Well, Hermogenes was enraged by this. He was very, very angry, and he decided that he was going to call the power of the demons to constrain Philetus, to hold him fast. And so that's what he did. He conjured up this spell, and he called the demons to come and to basically trap Philetus so that he couldn't move. And Philetus got word back to the Apostle James, who sent him his towel and said, you know, take this and, you know, I want you to pray this prayer. And so Philetus took the towel of the Apostle James, and he prayed this prayer from the Psalms, and his fetters are loosed and the demons are rendered powerless and he escapes. Well, then Hermogenes decided that he was going to call down the power of the demons to constrain both James and Philetus together. And so Philetus had gone and received baptism by this time at the hands of James. And so when these demons show up, James prays, and the Lord redirects those demons that Hermogenes had sent their way, redirects them to Hermogenes. And so then Hermogenes is terrified, he's frightened, and he realizes he's powerless against this apostle of God. And so he eventually comes, and he repents, and he is baptized, and he himself becomes a miracle-working preacher for Christ. Well, the Jews are enraged by this, and so they call upon Herod to persecute the Christians in Jerusalem, which they do, And we find in Acts chapter 14 that they kill James. They put him to death with the sword. It's notable, though, that on the way to his martyrdom, one of those Jews who had turned him in actually became a follower of Christ and was condemned to death with the Apostle James. And that as they are being led to their beheading, James, for good measure, heals one more paralytic along the side of the road. Just a beautiful story of the triumph of Christ over the power of death and darkness and the demons. Holy Apostle James, the brother of John the Apostle, the sons of thunder. Holy Apostle James, pray unto God for us. Christ is in our midst. He is and ever shall be.